Okay, everyone, I've been feverishly working on this airplane for the past 2 days now, and it's almost done. I just have to put the motor on, the receiver on, and the ESC on, and the battery as well. Let me show you it. So this was all hot glued together. We hot glued the wing to the main fuselage. We put a carbon fiber spar, which came with it, in the main wing there. We also put a carbon fiber spar right down the center of the bottom of the plane here. I put tape over the top and I hot glued them in, so they probably aren't going to go anywhere. That's where we have the receiver, and the servos are in the back here. This plane really didn't take too long to put together. There were only maybe five or so pieces. Let me show you what I did here. So this is the rudder push rod, and I put a little bit of a bend in it to make it go straight and more towards the rudder. So if we look at it from here, we can see that the push rod comes in nice and straight to the horn there, and has a little Z bend and then goes out to the servo. These are pretty heavy push rods. They don't bend very easily, and I think in this application, I think it'll work just fine. On the other side here is for the elevator there, and the servos were, everything was hot glued together, so the hot glue really works well. Taped up the control surfaces just because EPP may separate or come apart if used for a long period of time. And like I said, now the only thing I have to do is hook this motor up to it. I'm carving out the motor mount to go on the front of it. And then I'm going to mount the motor to it. Okay, everyone, we're down here at the field, and we're going to do the maiden flight of the Phoenix 80 Green. I got it all together, put the push rods in, and we're going to put this guy up in the air. We do have a prop saver on the front of it, and the motor mount was hot glued to the front. Everything looks really good. I'm hoping it's going to fly well, so we will see.
All right, guys, so now we just need to determine where to put the mount the battery so that we can get the correct CG. As you see, without the battery, you know, it's wicked tail heavy. Yes, I did use the word wicked. We're going to put it, I think, right around there. And I have some regular packing tape that I'm going to use just to tape it in place until we find the sweet spot, and then we can make like a battery mount or something for it. Let's check it again. That's sitting pretty good. Pretty perfect right there. So that might be the spot. Transmitter's turned on. We're just going to power it on. This is a hand-launch airplane. And when I do land it, I do have to be careful because the battery is down in the front there where it's going to hit the ground. And you just got to be careful that you don't break your battery and mess up the battery. So, maiden flight. Let's see what it can do.
I couldn't get that, Piazza.
You didn't get it?
No, because it came so close to me.
Alright, let's try it again. I'll try to go slow.
Make sure it don't hit me.
How's that?
Better.
See, it goes straight up when I give it gas. Do you have it?
Yeah. Another time.
Whoa! Alright, folks. Excellent first flight of the Phoenix 80. Wonderful job. Looking forward to teaching Stephanie how to fly this and any others who are interested in starting. This is an excellent, excellent trainer plane to begin with. So, thanks guys for watching. We'll see you again next time.